Hello, my name is Kelsey, and our hope for today is from Ephesians chapter 3, verses 14 to 21. And it's actually a prayer that Paul has written out as part of his letter to the church of Ephesus. Let me read it to you. For this reason, I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth derives its name. I pray that out of his glorious riches, he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power, together with all the Lord's holy people, to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled with the measure of all the fullness of God. Before I read Paul's final sentence in his prayer, I just want to pause and reflect with you on what Paul's saying about God's love. In typical Paul fashion, he's emphasizing that the people of God know God's love, but that they are still knowing God's love. That is a continued process, that they've already attained it, but that they are still continuing to understand it. And, you know, God's love is incredible. And as Paul says, it surpasses all knowledge. And a number of years ago, God actually really challenged me with this. And he wanted me to understand his love for me better. So I went on a 90-day fast, and I fasted all types of media. I would say the world's way of describing love. So I fasted chick flick movies. I stopped reading the novels I enjoyed to read. I went on no dates during that time. And I just spent 90 days focused on understanding God's love for me better. And every day I would go into my room in my journal, I'd write down a characteristic of God's love that I felt he showed me that day. And I thought I'd run out of things to say, but I was surprised with how that journal filled up with words that describe this love that is unlike anything on this planet. That this love that is surpassing, this love that frees you, this love that fills you with peace and joy, this love that heals, this love that pursues, all these amazing characteristics of God's love. And I ended those 90 days with my last thing that I wrote down saying that God's love is indescribable, that it will never fully be grasped by me. And that's amazing. That's great, because that means that we can continue to learn about God's love. And I love Paul's prayer, that he's praying that the people of Ephesus will just grasp more of God's love, recognizing that God's love surpasses our knowledge, but yet his prayer is that they would grasp just a little bit more of just how much God loves them. And that's my prayer for you today. May you go about your day grasping a little bit more just how much your Father God loves you. Let me read Paul's final sentence in his prayer. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us. To him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen. God bless.